Next week, got y'all losing y'all minds. Come on. Let me off this roller coaster.
Let me off this roller coaster. Hey, what is going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Junior's World of Soul. I am back with a new video. You know what I'm saying? To bless y'all with R&B the right way, the authentic way. But before y'all do anything, I want y'all to like this video. I want y'all to subscribe to Junior's World of Soul. I want y'all to click that bell so y'all can know every time I do a video. You know what I'm saying? But listen, I'm here to grant y'all some good R&B. You know what I'm saying? As you can hear, I came in with India Irie's powerful record, Roller Coaster. And as y'all can see, I'm like, let me off this roller coaster. Everything that's going on in our world right now, as far as this pandemic going on with this COVID-19, with these cases are rising and then people are not paying attention. Like, y'all, listen, just wear a mask. Like, for real, if everybody just wear a mask for like 2 months, this thing can go down, like, for real, y'all, seriously. And then again, you know, with police brutality and you know, with my black brothers out there getting killed for no reason, or it's just sad, you know what I'm saying? But again, y'all know how I stand for all Black Lives Matter, and I mean all, and I mean everybody included, because I feel like, yes, if you might be gay, you might be lesbian, you might be trans, but at the end of the day, you are black at the end of the day, and we all gotta stand together if we want change to happen for our community. You know what I'm saying? And this record from India Irie is such a powerful record. Recommend y'all definitely go listen to this joint off her Worthy album. And it's just, India Irie, y'all know she's for us. You know what I'm saying? So y'all check out that album and all that. But y'all know it's all about the music here. It's all about that. If you're new to Junior's World of Soul, this is all about current R&B bangers. Now, again, current R&B bangers is all about showing mainstream that R&B is alive and well. You know, right now, R&B is kind of at the bottom of the totem pole when it comes to music. You know what I'm saying? And it ain't cool. And it, you know, it gives the narrative that R&B is dying. So it's like when somebody comes out, it's like they're going to be the savior of R&B. I'm going to bring R&B back. It's here. It ain't going nowhere. It's just the mainstream is not spending their dollars, you know what I'm saying, to really push R&B like they do hip-hop and like they do pop music, and which is all the DNA of R&B music, so I don't understand that. But me as an R&B lover, I saw the transition in 2010, but I was always complaining on social media for 5 years, and I said, you know what? I'm going to create something that can give unsigned artists and signed artists, you know, R&B signed and unsigned artists, you know, a platform where their music can be heard. Because it's just a little annoying where it's like everybody's like, where's the R&B music? It's here. And we have the internet. You just got to search for it. But here at Junior's World of Soul, I got you. You know what I'm saying? And I normally give y'all 4 to 6 joints every week. You know what I'm saying? Just to prove mainstream wrong once again. Okay, but this week I got 4 joints for y'all today. You know what I'm saying? So let's get this started. Let's do this thing here, because I don't want to keep y'all too long. You know what I'm saying? Yes, that singing broad. I'm talking about Ledisi. I am talking about Ledisi. Now, she's really been a part of kind of my family since like 2003, because my mom has been a big fan of her. You know what I'm saying? She's been a big, huge fan of her ever since her Soul Singer album. But it wasn't like I wasn't paying attention, but it was like I wasn't on Ledisi. And I finally, it took me 4 years to finally really, really get on her. But I finally got on her doing her Lost and Found album, which I think is amazing, is dope. Y'all should definitely check it out. You know what I'm saying? I would love to just see Ledisi live, because she sings down, for real. Like, I love the video that kind of goes around a lot when her, Kelly Price, Marsha Ambrosius, and I forgot, it was somebody else. Kelly Price, Ledisi, Marsha Ambrosius, and I forgot. And they did 4 women. And Ledisi just bodied it at the end when she said, bitch, yeah! Like, she bodied that, man. Like, Oh God, I'm gonna put that in the more info box so y'all can check it out. But since then, since 2007, I have been a fan. I have talked about her so much on Current R&B Bangers, especially in 2017 when she came out with her album Let Love Rule. And I talked about so many joints on that album because she had some bangers. Shout out to DJ Camper that blessed her on this album. I talked about Add to Me. I talked about All the Way. I talked about For Us Together with her and BJ the Chicago Kid. And Here. And then my favorite song of 2017, which was her song High. I love that record. And I talked about it so much on Current R&B Bangers. Like, y'all should definitely check out that album and tell me what y'all think about it, man. Because DJ Camper gave us some heat on that album, for real. But I'm always happy when Let It See releases a new album. Like, I get just... Or a new song, because I just want to see where she's going to come. You know what I'm saying? Where she going to go with it. You know what I mean? So she released, which y'all hear in the background, Anything For You, which I talked about on Current R&B Bangers. And I was like, okay, so I know Let It See is coming out with a new album. She didn't say, but it was like, all right, you getting us ready for this new album. You know what I'm saying? And then I was right. And on August the 28th, she's coming out with her new album entitled The Wild Child, which I want to know where is she going with that, you know what I mean? But she just released her second single off the album. I don't know if it's the official second single or, you know, since the album is coming, you know, you're going to release another single, you know what I mean? Brandy, hello. But, yeah, she released a new single. This one, she worked with Ivan of Carvin and Ivan, who are, like, they are dope. And they've worked with her since... what, 2009, if I'm not mistaken? Yes, from her Turn Me Loose album. They've worked with her, so she has a relationship with them, and they make great music together. So when I saw that that they were kind of a part of this record, I was like, oh yeah, this is going to be dope. And then when I heard it got a nice beat to it, I was like, yo, I love it. And I was like, I'm going to talk about it on Current R&B Bangers. So this joint is entitled Where I Am. And this joint is dope, y'all. And this is the first joint of Current R&B Bangers. So here is Let It See with Where I Am. Here we go.
If you cannot handle it, if you want me, then meet me where I am. Where I am. You see where I am.
Hey.
So catch me if you can. Don't go back and down, baby.
Hey.
You need what I am. Catch me if you can.
That joint like a nice beat, like a nice little joint too. You know what I'm saying? Get a nice little two-step with your drink in your hand, like y'all do, like I always do. You know what I'm saying? But this joint is dope, man. It's a dope, dope joint. I'm so waiting for this album. I want to see where Let It See is going with it. You know what I'm saying? I see that she's definitely working with Calvin and Ivan. So I'm hype about that. So I want to just know where she going, y'all. August the 28th, the Wild Child album is coming out. Y'all check it out. But this joint, Where I Am. I'm thinking of Jay-Z, Brooklyn, Where I'm From. I'm sorry, y'all. Going to hip-hop and I'm there at R&B. I'm sorry. But Let It See's Where I Am. The joint is on all streaming platforms. Y'all check it out. And that's the first joint on Current R&B Bangers. I'm sorry, y'all. I took it to hip-hop for a second because I was thinking of Where I Am, Where I'm From, which is off Jay-Z Volume 1. And I'm thinking of that song because I am from Brooklyn representing. And I was just thinking about it and it kind of had me tongue-tied. And I messed up Let It See's thing. But y'all know we raw or true, so it's all good. So here we go. Let's get into the second joint. Like I said, I'm talking and I don't want to even keep y'all that long. So here we go.
Count me in, whoa, whoa, whoa. Count me in, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Hey, hey, hey. The duo that I'm so hyped that I found. I'm talking about that consists of Dante and Drew. I'm talking about they, period. And Dante is from Denver, Colorado. And Drew is from D.C. And let me tell you, they are musically dope. You know what I'm saying? I'm so hyped that I found them. You know what I'm saying? I didn't discover them. You know what I'm saying? Because you know, when people say they discover somebody, it's like, oh my God, they the first ones to find them. No, I actually found them. You know what I'm saying? Just looking on social media and I found Count Me In. And I'm like, yo, who is these dudes? You know what I'm saying? So then I had to go back, and of course, if I'm gonna talk about them, I had to do my research on them. You know what I mean? But you know, it's crazy because I kind of knew Dante before I even knew the group, because Dante worked with Brian Kennedy on Kelly Clarkson's Mr. Know-It-All, and I'm a big fan of Kelly Clarkson. And y'all know by now that I read liner notes, but I didn't put the two and two together until I watched the interview that they did, and Dante was like, yes, I got the first single off Kelly Clarkson's first album, off her album entitled Stronger. And I was like, wait a minute, he was on Mr. Know-It-All? And I was like, oh, snap. So I knew him, but I didn't know him, you know what I mean? But like these dudes, like I said, they like musically dope. You know what I mean? Because I like their inspirations, and you could tell they put it all in their music. They are inspired from people from Kurt Cobain to Babyface to Take Me Back Sunday to, you know, New Edition, and then they love hip hop. You know what I'm saying? And they put all that into their music, and you can definitely hear it on their album Religion. You know what I mean? Religion, the Hyena. Like, y'all gotta check that out, because It has the country, it has the rock, it has the pop, it has, you know, the trap, it has all that into one, and you can tell they are really real about their music. So I would recommend you guys check out Religion, you know what I mean? But, you know, if y'all hear Count Me In, which has that trap type of vibe, but it still has that 90s flavor to it, but it still has that new kind of school to it, you know what I'm saying? And I feel that it's honest, you know what I mean? And that's why I was like, yo, finding them, I was like, yo, this is so dope, you know what I'm saying? Because you don't have people that have some great music backgrounds, and then it's like they don't put it into their music, and these guys actually put it into their music, and they're young, you know what I'm saying? So that tells me right there, they are definitely music inclined, so I think that's dope. But I was hyped that they had a new single coming out, and they were talking about it on their social media, because, you know, right now everybody can talk on their social media. You can kind of get an interview with anybody right now because everybody's home. So I was like, oh, they got a new joint coming out. So yesterday I was on, you know, my Spotify, and I was kind of looking around, you know, trying to see what new music is out there. And then I go to Day, because I was like, let me see what's up with Day. And they got a new joint. And the joint is dope. It's with Tinashe. The joint is called Play Fight. I like it. It's a vibe. And I was like, I'm going to talk about it on Current R&B Bangers. So here's the second joint. This is from They. And this is entitled Play Fight. And here we go. It goes a little something like this. Here we go. Play fight, I'ma eat it like I don't know what it tastes like. Round four, next round, let you take five. Fuck around, keep going to the day. Yeah. Play fight, yeah. Play fight, yeah. Play fight, yeah. It got a nice little groove to it, you know what I'm saying? And then Tinashe comes in, you know what I'm saying, singing her ying around the house, you know what I'm saying, do her little thing on the record, you know what I'm saying? And I'm hearing like country on this, I'm hearing, you know, R&B flavor, you still got the little trap vibe going, and it's just a dope, dope joint, y'all, like for real, so listen. I need y'all to check out They. They're a dope group. You know what I'm saying? I'll put all the information in the more info box. But Play Fight, that joint is a nice banger. You know what I'm saying? You can't help but you can't stay still to the joint. You know what I'm saying? So that is the second joint of Current R&B Bangers that's coming from They, and that is Play Fight. Okay now. I'm excited. I'm really excited. I'm excited to talk about this next artist.
I got expectations with you.
Woo! Yes, God, that singing fool I'm talking about, Gene Noble. Like, Gene Noble is one of my favorite singers out right now. Like, for real. Like, the dude's vocals is out of control. No auto-tune needed at all. Don't need none of that. The dude can sing, yo, like for real. And I'm like, oh, I want this dude to blow so much. But since 2016, I've been a fan of this dude. Like, I have been a real fan. I have talked about him a couple of times on Current R&B Bangers when I was doing my radio show and I was doing my top five Current R&B Bangers every a month. I think I talked about Gene about 3-4 times. That's how dope and how talented and how, like, I want this dude to win and how much I want people to know that this dude can sing his face off. Like, did y'all just hear that vocal run right that he just did? And he did it with the falsetto. It's nothing to be played with. Like, his voice is nothing to play with. But if you don't know, you know what I'm saying about Gene. He was actually born in Kansas, but then he moved to New York. You know what I'm saying? I think Long Island, if I'm not mistaken. And, you know, it was like his pops passed, and it was like music was his outlet. You know what I'm saying? That was able to express himself. You know what I'm saying? And then he said after he saw D'Angelo on his Voodoo tour, he was like right then and there, he was like, yo, I want to be an artist. I want to be a performing artist. And then he went on about it. You know what I'm saying? And in 2014, he released his debut project, and listen, got some bangers on there. Imagine, Twilight, which is my joint, Still Here, Whenever You Are, and Lay Me Down, Lay You Down. Am I saying it right? Yeah, Lay You Down. Lay You Down. Let me tell you something right now. His vocal acrobatics on that song is nothing to be played with. Like, Gene sings down. And it's so crazy because I was actually introduced to him in 2016 from his duet that he did with Keisha Renee for Granted. And they bodied that. You hear me? They bodied that joint. And ever since then, I was like, yo, I'm a fan of this dude. Like, this dude, anything he does, I'm behind it. For real. Like, when he was on the Terrell show, like, I went crazy about it, and I even got a clip on my Instagram when he hit this note, and I almost dropped my phone from recording. I did, like, a yell, like, ah, oh, and, like, for real, like, he's nothing to play with. So, he's worked with so many people. He's worked with Shaggy, Sting. He worked with Chris Brown. He worked with Faith and so many others. But I, you know, I was so hyped as a fan when he was in the NAACP Awards, and he was singing background, him and Donis with Jill Scott. I lost it. I was like, yo, there go Gene. Like, yo, be singing background for Jill Scott. I was hyped. I was like, yo, he doing it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Even though he was on tour with Shaggy and Sting, and they had a record that was top 40, like, all over the world. So he was, like, touring over the world, like, all that. But at the end of the day, just to see him doing background for Jill Scott, And you know, they killing it, and it just is like, yo, I just want him to win, because the dude can really sing, you know what I mean? And we need those male vocalists again to teach these youngins what singing really is, and Gene can definitely do that, okay? But he keeps blessing us with music, you know, not albums. He blessing us with, like, singles, Brighter Days. And then he also did a joint that's so powerful that I talked about here. I actually opened the show with his powerful Too Many Lives Lost. Y'all definitely need Too Many Lost. I'm sorry. Too Many Lost. Y'all definitely need to check that out. Like, it's a powerful record. You know what I'm saying? He's definitely for the movement. You know what I'm saying? All Black Lives Matter. So respect to him on that. But I'm so happy he got a new single out. I was like, when I heard it, I was like, I don't even care if it's bad, because I knew it wouldn't be. And the joint is entitled Matching Tattoos, and this joint is crazy. And on his Instagram, he was asking people, would you ever get a matching tattoo? And I said, oh, hell no, negative. The only ones I got is the ones that I know that's going to be around forever, and that's my mom and my two grandmas. That's it. You know what I'm saying? I ain't getting no matching tattoo with nobody else. Sorry. I was like, no, sir. It ain't happening. But this song is dope. And if you really listen to the words, he said, I'm glad we didn't get the matching tattoos. Okay? So here is Matching Tattoos. And this joint is a banger. I like it. And here we go. Goes a little something like this.
Aren't you glad that we didn't go through getting the matching tattoos?
Ah!
Whatever we had,
fading from view. Cause we don't got matching tattoos.
Hey!
Cause I don't rock with you.
I don't rock with you. I don't rock with you. That's why I'm glad we didn't get the matching tattoo, because I ain't rocking with you now. Like, let me tell you something. Gene is talking his shit on this. I don't care what nobody said. See, when you see it, you thinking he talking about, oh, this is a nice thing, we getting matching tattoos. No, he talking his shit on this record. And then when he said, I know the way I hit it, you ain't getting no better. Like, I'm like, Gene, you better talk your shit on this record. Like, for real. Like, this joint is dope. Y'all, like, go stream this joint, stream a tattoo, support this real singer, no auto-tune at all, and he's showing you that he can really sing, and we need him in this game. So y'all, matching tattoos, Gene Noble, I'm going to put all his information in the more info box. I definitely want y'all to check him out, and that is the third joint of current R&B bangers, and that is from my boy, Gene Noble. Woo! Alrighty, man, I'll be so hyped. Talk about him, man. Cause I'm such a fan. All right, here we go. Look at my whole face. Hey, 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 my phone, leave me alone. I'm just stuck in my whole face. And I don't know if I could change. Hey, hey, ha ha. The Columbus, Ohio native, now who's living safely, hopefully, in LA. And I'm talking about Christian Lier. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Christian Lier. And you could, I'm a fan of this dude, and you can tell his influences by the way he sings. Clearly, Brandy done influenced a lot of these singers. You could definitely tell he's influenced by Usher, and he's influenced by Janet. You could definitely tell by the music that he makes. It's very sexy music. So you can tell he's definitely influenced by Janet. Now, I was actually introduced to Christian by his offline album, which he released in 2018, and I talked about it here on Current R&B Bangers, and it was a song entitled Bleed. And I give y'all a little bit of that. Mm, 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 mm. Hey,
we all gotta think of your mind. Take your love to watch me play. I feel like I'm dying, please.
Like,
you're like, watch me bleed.
Like, that song, when I heard it, when I heard Bleed, I was like, yo, this gives me Brandy. Like, it gave me Brandy, human era type of vibes, especially how he's attacking this song vocally. I was like, yo, I like this. You know what I'm saying? Then I checked out the whole album, and, definitely recommend you guys, you know what I'm saying, check it out, you know what I'm saying. Definitely the vocal acrobatics that he does on this, you definitely tell he's from the school of Brandy, you know what I'm saying. But definitely check that out. I'll put that in the more info box, because I think that's on his SoundCloud page, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, it could be also on all streaming platforms. If it is, I'm going to put it in the more info box. But right now, Christian is breaking the internet right now. This is what he's doing right now. And you know you are, Christian. This is exactly what you're doing. You know what you're doing. He's breaking the internet with his new project that he's entitled Offline 2. And especially after that video he just did for Whole Phase. I'll put that in the more info box. Y'all check it out for yourselves. It's like he going, listen, breaking the internet. For real, for real. But basically, when I listen to Offline 2, it's like basically he's just basically picking up where he left off Offline 1, which I think was dope as well. Offline 2 is smooth, you know what I'm saying, and definitely have some bops. Goals, how he started it off, like I hit him on social media and I told him the way he ended it with that vocal run at the end with the falsetto, I was like, whoa, you had to end it like this? This how you coming at people? I can dig it. You know what I'm saying? But, dang, where did I learn? Hold on. Nigga said, okay, yeah. So yeah, the way he ended that, I was like, yo, that's crazy. So, definitely it's an EP. I definitely digged it. Greedy, Pardon Me, and Look At You is my favorite. But it was one song that I kept playing over and over again. I was like, yeah, this joint is a banger. It was Overdose. And Overdose is kind of like a smash to me. It kind of gives me a little bit of an island feeling, but it's definitely a nice little upbeat summer joint. And I was like, yeah, this joint is dope. You know what I'm saying? So I was going to talk about this. So the fourth joint of current R&B bangers is coming from Christian Lier. And here is Overdose. Here we go. Got a nice little island groove to it, you know what I'm saying? You can't help but to stay still to the joint. Get my salsa on a little bit to this joint. This joint is a nice little smooth joint, you know what I'm saying? Offline is real smooth, you know what I'm saying? He got the bops on there, the current joints on there, you know what I'm saying? Like when y'all heard Whole Phase, and then Goals, and then he got, you know, the joints when he's singing on, when he's trying to show you them woo, you know what I'm saying? Trying to show you them vocals, you know what I'm saying? And all that, but again, y'all gotta check out the video for Whole Phase. Like I said, he is breaking internets with that joint. But I would definitely recommend you guys check out Offline 2. It's on all streaming platforms. And y'all check it out. Support the dude. So this joint is from Christian Lier. And that is Overdose. All right, y'all. Those are your four joints for the week that I blessed y'all with. It's Let Us See Where I Am. They with Play Fight. Gene Noble with Matching Tattoos. And Christian Lier with Overdose. Right then and there, y'all, I showed y'all, I gave y'all different vibes, you know what I'm saying? Y'all got fast, you know what I'm saying? You got mid-tempos, you got some ballads, you know what I'm saying? Y'all got a nice mix of stuff, you know what I'm saying? So don't let people tell y'all that R&B is not alive and well, because it definitely, definitely is. And I just proved it in this one, you know what I mean? But I want to talk to y'all. Me and my sister in music and in life, my sister Elise, we have a new show that we're doing on Instagram on Tuesday nights. It's we are the R&B representatives. We representing R&B the right way, people. Like I always say in the beginning of my videos, but we are the R&B representatives. And basically, we just gonna give y'all the dramatics. We gonna give y'all good music. We gonna give y'all musical history. We gonna give y'all some shadiness. We gonna be silly and all that good stuff. But please, y'all, come check us out on Tuesdays at 8 p.m. on Instagram Live. I'll put all our information in the more info box. This is our second show. Our second show we're doing on Summer Jams. So y'all, we going, you know what I'm saying? I might have a bid for this one, you know what I'm saying? For the Summer Jams, we're going to give y'all all the dramatics. I'm so excited. But y'all, please check us out. We're going to create our Instagram page, Facebook, all that good stuff. We just starting it, but the R&B representatives, we are here and we representing, you know what I'm saying? But y'all know how I do. I like to come in with a new joint, but I like to exit with a classic joint. And this classic, 55 years ago today, was the number one song on the R&B charts, coming from my favorite label of all time. I'm talking about Motown Records. And this classic is from the Four Tops, and here we go.
I can't help myself. I love you and nobody else.
I'm out, y'all. Peace.